In this video, I go over some of the common causes of the JoinDomain error when deploying Windows Virtual Desktop. Hello everyone, I'm Travis and this is Geraldos. I posted an article a few months ago to help people who maybe experience an error with joining Windows Virtual Desktop Session Host to a domain during a deployment. In this video, I go over some of the more common causes and give recommendations to resolve the issue. I also give a tip at the end that should make troubleshooting the issue easier. Before that, please subscribe, like, share, and all that good stuff. It helps my channel and it is appreciated. To start, let's go over what's happening in Windows Virtual Desktop when you run a deployment. After the session host VMs are deployed, a configuration script joins the session host to a Windows AD or Azure AD domain services domain. The join domain error is caused by the script failing to join the computer to the domain. Windows Virtual Desktop has prerequisites. It's not like app services where you can deploy and then access by a web URL. If there are any problems with these prerequisites, that will cause issues with the deployment. Windows Virtual Desktop requires a working Active Directory environment. This can either be Windows Active Directory or Azure AD domain services. If you're not clear on the differences between the versions of Active Directory, check out my video on directory services for clarification. Also required is network connectivity between the session host and the version of Active Directory you're deploying to. The domain join error could have different causes based on the type of AD you use. Let's start with Windows AD. A Windows AD domain can be connected to Azure either by a site-to-site VPN connection, Express route, or you could have a domain controller deployed to Azure, or a combination. Any configuration will work as long as a session host deployed to Azure can connect to the Windows AD domain. Network connectivity is dependent on the VNet. The VNet session hosts are deployed to need connectivity to a domain controller. One common problem with deploying Windows Virtual Desktop is the default settings for deploying a host pool was to create a new VNet. A VNet by default does not have connectivity to any other VNet. That requires a VPN connection or VNet peering. So if you deploy a new VNet, that VNet cannot communicate with the VNet that has access to the domain controller, and the deployment will fail with a domain join error. The image on the screen shows the settings from the Azure portal. Notice the note that it has to have connectivity to a domain controller. Also, with Spring Update 2020, it no longer defaults to a new VNet. It asks you to select an existing VNet. The first tip is when using Windows AD, be sure the VNet has connectivity to the domain controller. While on the topic, there's one other setting that needs to be changed when deploying session host and using Windows AD. The DNS servers on the VNet has to be configured to domain DNS servers, commonly set to Windows domain controllers. Why is this? When you add a computer to the domain, the computer uses DNS to find resources, such as domain controllers for that domain. If you leave the DNS server to the default Azure public DNS server, the computer will not be able to locate domain resources and the domain join task will fail. Just like on-premises, DNS has to point to domain DNS servers for the client to join the domain. The DNS settings are found in the VNet properties and apply to any dynamically assigned DNS in that VNet. Tip 2 is when using Windows AD, set the DNS servers on the VNet to the domain DNS servers. Let's move on to Azure AD domain services next. If this is the configuration you're using and having problems, take a look at my video on deploying Azure AD domain services and joining a computer to the domain. This will give you insight into the details of how to deploy and configure Windows AD domain services and then join a computer to that domain. Just like Windows AD, session hosts joining an Azure AD domain services domain need connectivity to the domain. Be sure to deploy the session host to a VNet with connectivity to the domain. This is typically done by adding them to the subnet and the same VNet as Azure AD domain services. Alternatively, you can deploy the session host to a different VNet as long as there's connectivity with VPN or VNet peering before the host is deployed. The third tip, when using Azure AD domain services, be sure the session hosts have connectivity to the domain. You can probably spot a theme here. Just like Windows AD, Azure AD domain services is dependent on DNS. The session host will use DNS to locate the domain resources when joining the domain. be sure to complete the Azure AD Domain Services setup by updating the DNS server setting on the VNet. Also, if you do deploy to a different VNet for Windows Virtual Desktop, the DNS settings will need to be manually updated on that VNet also. Tip 4, when using Azure AD Domain Services, be sure that DNS server settings are updated. Something else to be aware of with Azure AD Domain Services. User accounts for Azure AD Domain Services can be sourced from Windows AD, replicated to Azure AD, and then to Azure AD Domain Services, or they can be created in Azure AD and then replicated to Azure AD Domain Services, or simply created in Azure AD Domain Services. If you deploy Azure AD Domain Services and use a domain join account sourced from Azure AD, be sure to change the password on that account after deploying Azure AD Domain Services. Here's why. Azure AD stores a hash of the password, but it's not in the legacy NTLM format needed by Azure AD Domain Services. Azure AD also does not store the password in a format that it can generate the legacy NTLM hash from. When Azure AD Domain Services is deployed to the tenant, the Azure AD tenant will start creating the legacy NTLM password hash format the next time the user changes their password. So if the password for the domain join account is not changed, there's no valid password hash in Azure AD Domain Services, and you'll get an account disabled or locked out error message. So my fifth tip, when using Azure AD source domain join accounts, change the password on the domain join account after deploying Azure AD Domain Services. Speaking of domain joined accounts, if using Azure AD Domain Services with accounts synchronized from Windows AD, legacy NTLM hash synchronization has to be configured in AD Connect. This is different from password hash synchronization used for Azure AD. Check out my video on Azure AD Domain Services for more detail. At this point, there should be connectivity between the session host and the domain services. DNS is in place and the password synchronizing. The next thing to verify is that there's no network security groups blocking traffic between the session host and the domain controllers. Network security groups can be applied to the network interface or the subnets. If you have network security groups in place, make sure that they're not blocking communication between the session host and the domain controllers. Tip number 6, make sure there's no network security groups blocking traffic between the domain controllers and the session hosts. That takes care of the most common issues. I have one more recommendation if you're still troubleshooting the issue after checking the above. This removes Windows Virtual Desktop from the equation to isolate if the problem is Windows Virtual Desktop or something else in the environment. Deploy a Windows VM. It can be Server 2016, 2019, or even Windows 10. Deploy it to the same VNet and subnet that you're deploying the session host to. Once deployed, use the same domain join username and password combination used for the Windows Virtual Desktop deployment to add the computer to the domain. If it fails, that means there's a problem with the prerequisites and the Windows Virtual Desktop will fail also. This will help identify if the source of the issue is Windows Virtual Desktop or something else in your environment. So the last tip, join a computer to the domain from the same subnet and with the same domain join account outside of Windows Virtual Desktop. I hope this helps with identifying the issues causing domain join errors. If you have any other tips, please add them to the comments below. Thanks for watching.